We're joined now by Sarahun Hattapalu. He's the CEO of the risk analysis firm Berry and a CGTN Global Economics Analyst. Thank you so much for joining us.
Good evening, Elaine.
So, you know, the G20 is getting underway. Free trade, global economic governance, climate change, just some of the big issues that will be discussed in Buenos Aires. But, you know, a lot is being said about this Trump-Xi meeting. How much of this trade war will dominate the summit?
I think it's going to dominate the entire thing, pretty much, because not only is the United States or China is affected by it, but also neighbors in Asia Pacific, European countries will be affected by it too. Because, but it's not if there's not a permanent agreement here, that doesn't mean that there will not be in the future. All everyone is hoping at this point is a handshake, a hearty handshake, and a commitment to opening trade talks. And I think it looks like that's going to be the case after this meeting.
Yeah, a lot is being said about potentially a discussion to sort of put a pause on the tariff and the trade war, push it off until spring with more talks. What's the possibility of that happening?
I think it's, I wouldn't even say the possibility, I think it's a probability. It is really, really high probability because, look, the United States, if we look at the stock market here in October and November, they were horrendous months. And for this president, stock market is very important. It's pretty much related to his popularity. That's what he sees. And I will tell you that the stock market cannot take another hit at this point. It's just started to recover a little bit, but it's shaky. And if there's not even a kind of a little sign that this is not going to work out, we're going to feel it in the stock market. And that's going to affect the Asian markets. That's going to affect the European markets. So I think that the pressure is really on these two leaders. And I think, like I said, there's going to be a short-term pause in the trade war and a commitment to more trade talks in the next 3 to 6 months.
U.S. Federal Reserve coming out and speaking ahead of the G20 as well as the IMF. I want to ask you about this report by a monitoring group, the Global Trade Alert. It's saying that the scale of the U.S.-China trade war is actually bigger than what is generally being reported, 20% higher. If that is true, how does that play into Saturday's discussion between the presidents of the United States and China?
Well, it is true because a lot of the times when you look at the numbers that are being reported, they don't include or integrate the supply chains.
They're saying $369 billion versus $278 billion.
I'm not surprised. I don't know about the numbers, but I'm not surprised. And it sounds about right because if you take into supply chain, the global economy is still integrated despite everything that we've gone through in the past 2 years. And that's going to have an impact. It already is, by the way, to supply chain in companies in the European countries as well as in the United States. There are some countries actually benefiting from that. Vietnam, Malaysia, Taiwan, they're getting more and more companies located there to avoid the tariffs. So a lot is at stake here. There's going to be a serious discussion about this, but I think it's not about the numbers for the United States. I think it's about policy. And the United States has a problem with the China 2025 policy, and that's why I'm not hopeful that the issue is going to be resolved. I'm just optimistic in the short term that there's going to be a pause.
All right, we'll have to wait and see what happens on Saturday. Sarahun, always great to hear your insight.
Pleasure to be here.